This is a special reunion. Cassius is about to turn 50, making him the oldest male chimpanzee in the whole of Australasia. And he wouldn't be here today if it weren't for Tom Wyatt.
Well, I haven't seen him for 10 years, might have been a bit longer to see him. And he was sort of like a stunned mullet, is it, or isn't it? Was it? Because his mate died, and it was only him and I. And he got overexcited, went around the cage, bashing the doors.
35 years ago, Cassius and his brother Ockie were on death row. Tom Wyatt was watching TV and saw the news that a mother and her two offspring at a small zoo in Tweed Heads were about to be euthanased.
So through all the argy-bargy, next morning I rounded up all the troops. My great friend here designed the zoo just like that. And Bob Beasley was the welder. And everyone had a job to do, putting rocks in and putting rocks out. And we had it all ready within a week. It was all ready. And so Jim and I and John Broad went to Coolangatta, drove to Coolangatta non-stop. We drove to Coolangatta because they're going to put them down the next morning. That's what they told us. So we didn't give them that opportunity.
It was a great adventure for Tom and I when we heard they were going to put these chimps down. And so I rung Tom and we got on the car, in the car, went down to the case to save them. And that was a very important part in our life. About 9 o'clock at night when I finished work and I'd rung Tom and he said, yeah, he is coming. And away we went. And I was a fast driver. Tom was cocking because he was so scared. But we had a great time together.
A local trucking company transporting timber also came to the rescue.
Well, we welded up another two cages, individual cages as big as that, that sat on top of the timber. And and Jim said to the driver, don't stop until you get to Queensland. And he said, all right. He said, we better go meet him over the border. So we did and met him over the border. And when the bloke found out what we had in them cages, he said, for Christ's sake, get going, mate. So we kept going until we got to here and the chimps were coming too. You know, but in the lead up to them being hijacked by us, the chimps were just starting to groan and roll and run around, and of course Barry Elliott, he rode with them in the truck. He was the zookeeper those days, and he settled them down. Jeff Murphy got up there with slinging cranes and all that sort of stuff. And we got them housed in the thing, but it took another 48 hours for them to overcome the trauma we put them through. But everybody just loved those chimps. No one would be game to take those chimps away, ever.
Well, that's just it. Like, when you think about it, if Cass and Ockie hadn't have been rescued and never came to Rockhampton Zoo, we probably wouldn't have chimps today.
Rockhampton Zoo is now one of five zoos in Australasia that are part of an important breeding program, with a third baby in just 4 years due this December.
We actually have some of the best genetics with the chimps that we have here because our chimps aren't related to the other chimps. Alon and Leaky, they came from a zoo in Israel, so they're completely new genetics. So it's quite important, these infants that are coming through our group, because it's adding new genetics to our population through Australasia, which creates a viable species management plan into the future. Five pregnancies in 3 or 4 years, it's pretty exciting. And then Cassius is obviously turning 50. Next to Cassius, the next oldest male is Boyd down at Monado Zoo, who I believe has just turned 40. So there's about a 10-year difference between the oldest male and the next oldest male in the region. He's a pretty important chimp, and it's a huge milestone. It really is a huge milestone for Cass to reach 50. It's incredible for any chimpanzee male to live to around 50, especially a chimpanzee that has been through the history that Cass has. It's nice to hear it firsthand from the people that are actually involved. And it was actually really sweet to see Cass's reaction to them today. He was a bit unsure to start with. You could see that he was like, they look familiar. And then Cass went straight in for a hand kiss, which was really, really adorable. So chimps, they never forget. When I started working with chimps, I was always told, you know, if you leave a chimp group, sometimes the best thing to do is to never go back, because when you leave and if you're gone for an extended period, the chimps think that you've died. So coming back can set off a whole lot of emotions. But yeah, they do remember. So Cass will remember, even as you age, they still recognise those facial features and whatnot. So when Cassius or Tommy came over and he did punch the glass, because he seemed to have picked Cass out, because Cass was around the corner. He picked out Tom, saw him, came over and kicked the glass, and like a kind of, where have you been? And then Tom put his hand down to the glass and Cass tried to kiss him through the glass and then sat there trying to interact with him through the window, yeah.
Well, if there was a flap or something there for me to let him strike my hand, he'd be in. Thank you.